Hey guys, this is Captain Greg. Really excited to be here with you today. It's summer story times, and every Tuesday and Thursdays, the Orange County Fire Authority will be here reading you guys a story, and we're really excited about that. So today, I get to read about one of my favorite characters with you, Curious George. Now, how many of you out there have watched the Curious George shows or watched the Curious George videos or read the books? Now, I, almost every day off, watch at least one Curious George show with my two kids, and my favorite episode is one where Curious George goes up into outer space. What are your guys' favorite episodes? All right, today we're gonna read about Curious George at the fire station. Really exciting, and we're here in the fire station shooting this right now. George and the man with the yellow hat were visiting the fire station. You guys see George and the man in the yellow hat are there to go see the firefighters and say hi to them? "Hello, George," said the fire chief. "How would you like to wear a fireman's hat?" You guys see the chief right there with the fireman's hat? How many of you would like to try on a fireman's hat? George put on the big hat. You can see little Georgie right there putting on the hat. Looks like he's really excited. Looks like he might have a question too. Then they looked at the fire engines. "We're proud of them," said the chief. "We keep them as bright and shiny as we can." You guys can see George and the man with the yellow hat looking at the fire engines, just like the fire engine behind me. We spend a lot of time here making sure that our fire engines are nice and clean and ready to respond to help you guys. One fireman was polishing a big brass bell on the wall. "This is our alarm bell," said the fire chief. "Whenever there's a fire, it rings." You guys can see the bell. Now, whenever we get a call here at the fire station, there's a big bell that goes off for us, and we know it's time to go help somebody, just like in George's book. Another bell was on the engine. You guys see the bell on the engine right there? "We ring that bell on the way to the fire," said the chief, "so that people will get out of the way." Kind of like us, we have the big siren and the horn that we use to let you know that we're coming on an emergency. And when you guys hear that, remember to tell mom and dad to pull the car all the way to the right and stop so we can get by to help somebody, okay? "And this is Sally, our Dalmatian. She just had 10 puppies. The puppies stay in a basket on the second floor with the firemen." You guys see little George looking at Sally with the right there, the little Dalmatian from the station? How many of you have dogs at home? I know I do, I have a golden retriever. They all went up to the second floor. The puppies were in a straw basket by the wall. Okay, see, now that's where the firemen sleep, so you can see the beds, and they got a TV there so they can keep up to date on what's going on. And then there are the little puppies in a basket right there. "Yip, yip, yip," they barked. One tried to jump up and lick George's face. Look at the little puppy trying to lick Georgie right there. Georgie looks like he's pretty excited with that puppy, huh? Near the basket was a big round hole with a pole in the middle. "When the alarm rings," said the fire chief, "the firemen slide down the pole to the fire engines below." You can see the pole right there. Now the station we're at today doesn't have a pole, but we do have some fire stations with poles, and you go really, really fast down the poles. It's really exciting, or sometimes scary for some people. Do you guys think it would be exciting to go down the pole? I bet you do.
"You may slide down it if you want, George," said the chief, "but be careful," said the man with the yellow hat. You can look at, see George right there. He looks a little nervous to go down the pole. I think he's gonna do it. What do you guys think? George slid down the pole like a real fireman. See, we knew he would do it. There's Georgie going down the pole. Then he climbed onto the fire engine. Looks like George is getting the full tour. He's getting to go everywhere at the station, up on the fire engine. How many of you guys would like to go on a fire engine one day? It's pretty fun. And then George sat behind the steering wheel. Wow, I wonder if they're gonna let George drive the fire engine. I don't think so. Do you guys know the person who drives the fire engine? We call him the engineer. Really important job.
"Make way, here comes George the fireman." Wow, looks
Looks like George is super excited. I think he's just pretending though. George was curious, what would happen if he rang the bell? What do you guys think is gonna happen if George rings the bell? You think all the guys are gonna come run down maybe? I think that might happen. Clang, clang, clang went the bell. Uh-oh, you can see the bell going off right there. What happens next? The fireman heard it and jumped out of bed. Uh-oh, looks like George tricked him. They all jumped up. Looks like they're ready to run and go on a fire or help somebody. Fire, 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 they shouted. Looks like they think there's a big fire. That's what we do when the bell goes off. We run to go help somebody. Quickly, they put on their uniforms and slid down the pole. You can see all the firemen putting their gear on, getting ready to go help somebody. It was a false alarm. See, we knew it. When the firemen got to the engine, all they saw was a little monkey. Uh-oh, Georgie tricked them all, just like we knew he would. George, said the fire chief, fighting fires is serious business. Get off that engine right now. George felt terrible. Uh-oh. Think George learned a pretty important lesson though, didn't he? We don't want to have false alarms, right? Or say things that aren't true. So George is learning this one the hard way, I think. At that moment, they heard a dog bark. Sally was looking up to the top of the fire pole. You can see Sally, the station Dalmatian, looking up. One of the puppies had gotten out of its basket and was looking over the edge of the hole. One more step and it would fall. Oh my goodness, now this might be a real emergency. We wouldn't want that puppy to fall, would we? Who do you think is gonna save the day? George knew what to do. He climbed up the pole as fast as he could. You see George climbing up that pole? Then he held out his hat to catch the puppy in case it should fall. Sure enough, the puppy slipped and what do you think happens, guys? Is George gonna catch the puppy? I'm gonna go ahead and vote yes. I think George is gonna save the day. He somehow always seems to at the end. Plop! Landed right in George's hat. See, we knew it. George saved the day. George is our hero. That was using your head, George, said the chief. You saved the puppy. I'm making you an honorary fireman of our station. You can keep the hat too. Wow, you see George getting the hat? He got to try on the hat originally when he got there, and now he's getting to keep it. What a lucky little monkey, huh? Come back to visit us anytime, shouted the chief, as George and the man in the yellow hat got into their car to drive home. You can see George and the man in the yellow hat driving home. Wow, what a great book, huh, guys? Was that a fun story to read? I know I had a fun time listening to George and hearing about his experience in the firehouse. I wonder if George is gonna stop by my fire station later tonight and say hi to me or come visit me. What do you guys think? Maybe? Well, thanks for being here with me today, guys, to let me read you. It was really fun. And we're looking forward to, you know, sometime in the future seeing you guys out there and waving at us when we're on the fire engine, okay? And be sure to always listen to Mom and Dad, okay? Thanks, guys. See you next time.